Out the light, Take off your shoes, don't fight. Lean back, relax, 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 relax.
But don't you see, my dear, we must assume that if they knew your partner well enough to put a knife into his back, they've got to know who you are, too.
I don't want you to make a touch unless we find you a new associate.
And I have someone in mind. Hold on just a second. Yes, here we are. He's been out of our operation for some time now, sort of on a semi-permanent leave, you might say. I've been told he's a photographer now and thoroughly enjoying his work, so it might be a little difficult to convince him, but he's the right man and he's in the right place. Let's just hope he's in condition. He had some rather peculiar ideas about keeping in shape, as I recall.
Saddles in that old corral. Who wants a ride tonight? If you knew Susie like I know Susie, what a gal, how I love her, I'm dreaming of her. She made breakfast and the cover, how we're dancing. Just look where it led. I'm in the dream and he's still in bed.
Hello.
McDonald calling.
McDonald calling? Oh, sorry.
What do you mean you're not home?
Matt Helm's on an assignment at Cape Kennedy.
Look, you're still on Uncle Sam's payroll, and I've got an assignment for you.
K-E-N-N-E-D-Y, Kennedy.
That's right.
Yeah. Last I heard, he was up one of them space capsules.
Way up. Good morning. Oh. The soap, please, Miss Craves It. Thank you. I feel clean all over, and no unsightly lather.
Miss Craves It?
Mr. Helm, would you please call me by my first name?
Well, I don't know your first name.
It's Lavi.
Lavi Craves It? Mm-hmm. Oh, that's some kind of name. Lavi, send a telegram.
What?
Walter Castleman, Slaymate Magazine, Chicago, Illinois. Dear Wall, I just completed photo spread today. We'll send results in plain brown wrapper. All the best. To the simple life. Wrong hacienda. Remember, I'm still up in that space capsule.
Mr. Helm is still in orbit. Try the moon in 48 hours. The area code there. It's Newsday Magazine.
Oh, hello, Chris. Yep, you just caught me in a dark room. Yeah. Oh, and I got a lot of great stuff from that Taos festival. Acapulco? Oh, I could be on my way tonight. Oh, Chris, could you make that 2 tickets? I'd like to take along my answering service. Yeah, you let me know. Bye, Chris. Mexico, Miss Craves It.
Lavi.
Lavi Craves It. You have been vaccinated.
Mm-hmm.
If I were a germ, that's the first place I'd look.
She doesn't answer, Mr. McDonald.
Keep trying, Miss Sherman. I've got to reach her.
Yes, sir.
What do you got, Frazier?
Another piece of the puzzle.
There's been some big O activity in this area. A number of their agents have been spotted.
Santa Fe, huh? Uncomfortably close to Alamogordo.
And the next underground atomic test.
Donald is right. They'll lead us straight to Big O.
Notice was short, but I see you're all here. Good.
Congratulations, Tung Se, on the latest missile disaster.
Did you like it? Thank you. Your report?
The next American missile shot takes place in 3 days, August 13th.
Their underground atomic test takes place the same day, August 13th.
It's an extraordinary coincidence.
We have worked for 5 years to arrange this extraordinary coincidence. And when we have used it for our purposes, vast areas of this country will be blanketed with radioactive matter. We shall have taken our first great step to conquest. Operation Fallout now lacks only one element, one vital piece of information. Andreev.
I've been in contact with the American scientist. He will deliver the computer tape to Phoenix as planned.
You are aware of the consequences of failure.
The tape will be here in time. I guarantee it.
You once gave your assurance that our activities here would remain secret. But from what I have just seen on the road up there, another split second and you would have been caught. And you know by whom?
ICE.
Yes. ICE. American Intelligence and Counter-Espionage. We have now become the prime targets of their legal assassins.
One of their agents got through to the girl, but he was killed.
And you thought that would be the end of it. His death will only bring others, like today, and among them, Matt Helm.
Treasure hunt. She grabbed her hat and grabbed her coat, but left her rest here on the doorstep. She's got me all wound up.
Can't be Lavi.
I'm a-heading for the last roundup.
A girl.
Hello there.
I couldn't help noticing, but these are your clothes?
What if they are?
I know you have a headache, but don't take it out on me. I mean, what should I do with these?
Just throw them anywhere. I won't be needing them till morning.
Don't you think we should be introduced first?
You're Matt Helm.
It's good enough for me. Hold it now. I get the picture. You're a shill for the house.
I beg your pardon?
You were sent over by a certain party to entice me out of the space capsule, right?
McDonald sent me.
That's the fella. Honey, hand in your uniform. You're off the team. I'm doing Acapulco tomorrow.
Matt, there's work to be done. This happens to be important.
Well, so is Acapulco. I'm losing my tan.
We could work well together. What's in Acapulco that you can't find here?
Mexicans.
There must be some way to convince you.
Well, I'm open for suggestions. Wait. Stay as you are. You been vaccinated?
Mm-hmm. Why?
Oh, just a thought.
been a long while, Eric.
Tina.
Sorry for the interruption, but she likes a scratch.
Has it occurred to you that I might want to know what's happening here?
Aren't you going to thank me first?
Oh, sure.
Oh, you're welcome.
Now, who is that girl? She said McDonald sent her.
That's what she told my partner just before she killed him. You know Jim Traynor. You worked with him.
Who is she working for?
Recognize the trademark?
Big O.
Remember them?
Oh, yes, Tina. But I've been on leave from ICE for a long time. As far as I'm concerned, I am out of it.
You're never out of ICE.
Oh, don't give me that McDonald mystique.
Well, obviously, Big O thinks you're still on our side.
Well, they're just as wrong as McDonald, and tell him to stop calling because I don't want any part of it.
Mac, listen to me. An American scientist is defecting. He's handing over some computer tape tomorrow night in Phoenix.
Well, then you'd better get started.
I can't work alone. Besides, you know the territory.
Get yourself a map.
So you won't come along?
I'll send you a postcard from Acapulco.
Maybe you better take a shorter trip first. Over to that window.
Why didn't you tell me she brought her friends along?
I always save the best till last.
Four of them.
Who designed this house? Smith and Wesson? Careful. Like old times.
Yeah, especially with that body on the floor.
What'll we do with her?
Well, you put her on ice, let ice take care of her.
And what happens when the maid walks in the morning?
You're right. Let's put her in my bed so we don't arouse suspicion.
Bill. Get him as soon as he comes out.
Right.
It's a pity you had to kill her. She was real valuable to us. You need a purse?
Smile?
What?
You didn't smile.
Not in there, Matt. He'll pick us off.
We're bulletproof.
But not fireproof. That rifle's incendiary.
Get in.
Well, what happens if it's the gas tank?
Smokey, the bear won't like it. Get in.
Mobile unit, come in. Mobile unit, come in.
They missed.
How many men does it take?
No, don't try to follow them. We'll be waiting in Phoenix.
South of the border is the opposite way. Here I am heading for Big O and not the Big Ole. Farewell, Lavi craves it. Too bad I can't stray. With her vaccination down Mexico way. A dummy am I. Hello, Arizona. Bikinis, goodbye.
We've got plenty of time to get to Phoenix.
Well, there's a motel on the highway. We could stop and rest.
Well, aren't we domesticated?
Are you trying to be tough or just sentimental?
Sentimental.
It's better.
Do you remember the night on the Wilhelmstrasse? When we danced? Just the two of us.
Oh, never forget the music.
There was no music.
Well, then forget it.
Then the lights on the terrace went off. And we kissed. A long, long kiss. Remember? Like this. Does that bring it back?
Does it?
It was a wonderful night. Later the moon came up. And then
a man with a high-powered rifle stood out the window and was aiming right at us.
Yeah. You know, I often wondered why he never pulled the trigger.
Well, I guess everybody loves a lover.
Miss Batory will have room 1404, and I can put you in 1405, Mr. Helm. But the rooms won't be ready for a few minutes.
That's all right. I'll be in the patio.
Fine.
McDonald?
His assistant. You want to talk to him?
No, I'll tell it to McDonald.
Key, please.
Yes, sir. 1405.
Sunset, way out on the sea. Who asked you to bring home the ocean to me?
The farmers were hoping for rain.
Oh, did I do that?
Uh-huh.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry. I know I did. It's just like me. Here, let me help you.
Ma'am.
It's
just, I think the best thing for you to do is just leave me out in the sun to dry, okay?
Oh, of course. Gee. You really are a good sport about it. I'm surprised you didn't take umbrage.
Oh, I take a belt now and then.
Oh. Well, goodbye.
Goodbye.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry. Oh, please forgive me. I'm sorry. Oh. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh. Eddie, fix me a Bloody Mary with real blood.
I can't leave you alone for a second, can I?
Not if you want to keep me dry.
Quite a girl.
That is not a girl, Tina. That's a disaster area.
A message from Father. We catch the 10 o'clock show at the Slago Club tonight.
I take it that's where the tape changes hands.
Take it right.
Hi.
Hi.
Can I buy you a drink? I feel I owe you one. I'm sure I owe you one, too. I'd really feel better if you'd accept.
Thank you very much. I'll have scotch and soda, and she'll have aqua vita on the rocks.
I'll have to try that. Oh, my name's Gail Hendricks, and this is Sam Gunther.
I'm Matt Helm, and this is Mrs. Helm.
Oh, how do you do? Are you staying long in Phoenix?
Well, our plans are indefinite.
I just love it here. You know, they say the climate here is the best in the world, not to mention the scenery.
I wouldn't know about that. We're on our honeymoon.
Are you on a vacation?
I was on a tour, sightseeing tour. But the man in charge of our group kept taking me places that weren't in the brochure.
Where was that?
His room. Would you mind?
Oh. It's the wrong end, lady.
Oh, thanks. Oh.
Oh. Oh, no, it's all right. It's okay, baby.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I know you are. It's all right.
Mexico after all.
I must say, she got you undressed a lot faster than I ever did.
No contest. I just want to get this tent off of me.
Come on in. It's yester time, and I promise not to spill anything. Getting there is half the fun.
You're really loaded. It's Talk about a booby trap. That's a crazy holster. Making love to you is like playing Russian roulette.
Direct from every bachelor's dreams, the girl we've all been waiting for, the incomparable Sarita.
Him down in Santiago. In Santiago I got romantic. He held my hand and believe it or not, on a cool, cool evening in Chile it got hot. The moon was like an aphrodisiac, and I whispered, let's play Nisi Jack. Nice and easy, Jack, I feel frantic.
She's got the tape now. Who's she supposed to pass it to?
I don't know, but her instructions are to keep it and give it to us.
Well, you take her out by the stage exit, because I'll be coming through the alley in a cab. All right?
What could be sweeter? My happy heart whispered, you're home. La dolce vita. We did just what the Romans all do in Rome. It's twice as nice in Santiago. It's paradise in Santiago. In Santiago I found my true love. And it happened, believe it or not, on a cool, cool evening in Chile, when it got sweet and hot. On a cool, cool evening in Chile, it got hot. It got hot. But it got in Chile. It got hot. We'll be right back.
be sweeter. My happy heart whispered your home, La Dolce Vita. We did just what the Romans all do in Rome. And it's twice as nice in Santiago. It's paradise in Santiago. In Santiago I found my true love.
The Hendricks girl has it.
She's dead. She's dead. Somebody's killed her.
Move. We're getting out of here. Move.
What are you doing? Where are you taking me?
You can get it just as fast as she did. Now move. Don't open your mouth till you get to the hotel.
Well, how do you expect me to breathe?
Don't. Now, second team. In case it rains. All right, girls, come on. Thank the man for the pretty car.
Come on. Come on.
Hendricks, now that you only have one way out, cooperate with the government.
You're with the government? Mm-hmm. You mean you're doing all this with my tax money?
She's stunning. She's expecting her people to come for her.
Oh, maybe so. In fact, maybe some of her people may be right behind this door with a bullet waiting for the first person to go through, which is going to be you.
What are you, some kind of a nut?
The tape.
I told you I don't have any tape!
Watch the elevators. Tell me if anybody's coming.
You would have let them kill me. You would have let them kill me.
Yeah.
But what? Ah! You sadist, you enjoyed that, didn't you?
Not particularly.
Mr. Helm, now do I look like an enemy agent?
Well, I don't know. I haven't seen all the latest models yet.
I always seem to be interrupting you.
Well, why don't you try knocking?
Where did you find it?
None of your business.
Oh, no, no, I'll go and call.
Look, I am a citizen and I demand to speak to my lawyer.
Not a chance.
Look, even a real criminal has a right to one phone call. And if you don't trust me, then you call yourself. Area 213-555-4144.
All right.
Could be a signal.
Well, maybe it'll smoke them out.
Here.
Feeling better?
Except for a king-size headache. What happened to Tina?
Now, she's in her room. She got a bigger whiff of that stuff than you did, but she's coming around all right.
Oh, hair of the phone that bit me.
We found a capsule in your pocket.
Capsule?
The one with the tape in it.
Tape? What tape?
The computer tape, Matt. Get it? The computer tape? Matt, does Operation Fallout mean anything to you?
It's a story in my head.
It's an international nuclear conspiracy. Big O's been pouring millions of dollars into it. Unfortunately, that's all we know about it.
Well, what was on the tape?
A complete timetable for an underground atomic test. The test takes place in 2 days, Matt.
Why worry? They haven't got the tape.
No. And we didn't get the scientist who delivered it either. You happen to get a look at him?
I think I can recognize him.
Good. Get some pictures sent down from Washington. You can look him over.
Hey, what about, what's his name?
Who is what's his name?
The fellow, the piano player. Sam Gunther.
Oh. We think he's Big O's chief operative. Codename Cowboy. Right now, he's our best lead to Operation Fallout. That's where you come in.
Oh, come on, Mac. You suggesting that I go find him?
No. No, of course not. We think it'd be much better if he found you.
Yeah, you need this more than I do.
No, Matt. I'm serious. Sarita told us the central transmitting point for all Big O operatives is in San Juan.
That's if I go to San Juan.
Exactly.
Are you ready for Miss Hendricks?
Yes, by all means. Miss Hendricks.
Take your hands off me.
Okay.
You are a miserable man, that's what you are. Just leave me alone.
That's all, boys. Allow me, Miss.
Thank you.
There, now that you're properly attired, perhaps we can have a little talk.
Why are you holding me?
Well, it's quite simple. You took a capsule from Sarita at the club.
I didn't take it. She gave it to me.
Why'd you go to the club with Sam Gunther?
Because he asked me.
No, you're lying, Miss Hendricks.
You never believe anything I say, do you?
I believed that telephone bit, and that was a gasser.
I didn't know anything about that.
Miss Hendricks, let's get back to what happened at the club, shall we? Now, you say Sarita gave you the capsule. Why would you do a thing like that?
Well, I don't know. Maybe I have a kind face?
Yes, indeed you have. Even so...
She's lying. She is lying.
Oh, look. I was the first person to reach her. She pushed this capsule at me, and she said... And these are her very words. She said, they mustn't get their hands on it.
And you don't know what she was talking about?
No. But... I figured it had to be important. After all, somebody just shot her.
Yeah. Go on, please.
Well, she did say one more thing, and didn't make any sense, though. Well,
what was that?
Was wigwam at San Juan.
Oh, a grain of truth in that. But you're lying about everything else.
Lying? Lying? Oh! Oh, I'm terribly sorry. Does it hurt?
Yes, as a matter of fact, it does.
Well, come over here and put your head lower than your knees and blow into a paper bag. No, that's...
Hiccups.
You're under arrest, Miss Hendricks.
Well, it's his fault. He ducked.
I'm talking about the computer tape. Sarita, Sam Gunther.
Sam? Well... Ask Sam Gunther. He'll back up my story.
Sam Gunther happens to be an enemy agent, Miss Hendricks.
I'm in trouble.
Miss Hendricks, the wigwam in San Juan.
What about it?
Would you help me look for it?
What are you talking about?
Well, taking a trip together, you and me.
In the middle of a big investigation? He's a sex maniac.
No, hardly. Hardly, Miss Hendricks. What Mr. Helm means is that if we find out there's any truth to the San Juan part of your story, then we might be inclined to believe the rest of it.
Oh. Oh. So I either go with him or...
Or to a federal penitentiary.
We'll talk about the lesser of two evils. Well, okay, I... Don't have any choice, I guess.
Oh, straight night.
Well, just do me a favor and don't introduce me to anybody as Mrs. Helm.
Well, Mac, supposing she's telling the truth and she's not an enemy agent.
Well, then Big Old pick her up. They'll want to find out how much Zarita told her.
And on the other hand, what if she's lying and she is on their side?
Which is more likely, huh?
So she and I go to San Juan. Big O decides that she's talked, and again they pick her up.
Right. You and I think along the same lines. Either way, set a trap for yourself that could lead us right straight to the cowboy.
That's right.
All you have to do is walk into it.
Oh, not exactly.
Oh, well, no, we want you to walk out of it, too. And I've given some thought to that. There's a package on the way down from Washington. Be here first thing in the morning. But right now, I want you to get started on a good night's sleep, huh?
Just as soon as I check on my partner. Hi. How do you feel?
Well, I'm asking you.
Medically speaking?
Oh. Well, the doctor wants to keep me under observation for a couple of days.
I don't blame him. Shouldn't you be in bed? I have an early call in the morning.
You're leaving?
Afraid so. But the Hendricks girl.
With Bloody Mary? Matt, listen to me. Be careful. I want you back in one piece. And I bet that girl is booby-trapped.
Mac, are you sure you know what you're doing?
Well, it's never been used before, man. It's the only one of its kind. But actually, that's a point in your favor. Now, the ideal situation is let it fall into the hands of the enemy and hope that they'll turn it on you. Like this.
I think you'll find it in the yellow pages.
Yeah. And then if you want to... If you want to fire it forward, straight ahead, you just push the trigger forward. Ordnance calls it their reversible gun.
It's a beauty. It would be hard to resist, wouldn't it?
Yeah, well, this is only an auxiliary weapon to help you get into Big O headquarters. The heavy armament's over here. Yeah. It's one of yours. I took the liberty of borrowing it from your closet. Mm-hmm. You might notice we changed the buttons and we've added a few.
Yeah, they're a little on the bulky side, aren't they?
I bet maybe, but they have to be. You see, each one of them's carrying a very heavy explosive charge. Mm-hmm. No, they just snap on. They're like miniature hand grenades, Matt. So you rip them free, and on the count of three, they explode. I got a couple of extra here. I'll show you how they work. Ready?
Uh-huh.
One. Two. Now, you've only got eight of them on the jacket, Matt, so use them sparingly. Huh? What do you think?
Well, finally wearing something that'll knock them dead. But I don't know how I'm going to face my tailor.
Seems like a nice, sweet companion to have for a ride through this canyon. but big o'er me, with which is she, side by side.
Helm just went by.
Good. He just went by.
Tell him we'll smash them between us.
Right. Yes, he's leaving now. He says to smash Helm between you.
Spirited, maybe.
What am I doing here? A guy can get killed like this.
The cellar. Cowboy. I'm talking about Sam Gunther. Why are you protecting him? Hasn't it gotten through to you yet that some of your friends have written you off?
I wish you had done the same.
Look, if you have some wild idea that you're going to get out of this, you forget it. What do you know about Operation Fallout?
Are you in love with Sam Gunther? Is that it?
I will tell you one thing. You do know how to drive a car.
If it isn't Gunther, what is it? Loyalty to a cause? No, I'd like to know. Now, give me one good reason why you won't talk. One good reason.
I signed my name in blood.
Yeah. Pour yourself a drink.
No, thanks. They don't like us to drink on the job.
I would break the rule and pour it. And look, we may not be as lucky the next time, so in case something happens, what is your real name?
You know my real name. It is Gail Hendricks.
What's your code name?
Three dots and a dash, and if you're real nice, I'll show you my sorority handshake.
Well, look, maybe you don't know what the score is yet, but Big O thinks you turned him in, and they have got to kill you.
Big O! You are sick, you know that? S-I-Q-U-E, sick.
Mm-mm.
I want some music.
Come fly with me. Let's fly away.
If you don't turn him off, he's terrible.
Some exotic cruise, there's a bar in far, far.
Everybody loves somebody sometime.
Now there's a guy that can sing.
Everybody falls in love somehow.
All right, now, let's just relax. No more questions, just easy nights, relax.
Second the motion. Relax, enjoy the scenery, see America first.
There's a lot more where that came from.
I just don't think you're being clever. Thought I couldn't drink, couldn't I?
Something in my heart. That someplace is.
What's Operation Fallout?
That's for you to know and me to find out. I mean, vice reversa.
Are they going to explode one of our bombs?
Oh. All of them. Everyone!
And when is all this supposed to happen?
I really want to know.
Mm-hmm.
The first full moon. What are you doing?
Well, we're 50 miles from the nearest town, and I don't care to play tag in the dark with your friends.
Just where do you suppose we're going to sleep?
That answer your question?
Your own little sex wagon. You gonna lock me in?
If you don't run away.
Wouldn't I?
It's much safer in here than it is out there. Have a drink.
Thank you.
You know, I think I know what you're after. I think you want to see how much mileage you can get on a full tank. And if that's what you're after, forget it. Cause, pardon me. See, I can handle everything you've got. And that little portable liquor store. Matter of fact, I can table you under the drink anytime at all.
That's better.
Better take those clothes off before you catch pneumonia. Well, at least take the shoe off and your stockings off. You do it.
you got to lose a little, win a little, get her out into the rain a little. That's the story of, that's the glory of love.
You undressed me once and I didn't like it.
Now you're confusing romance with first aid.
You get back in the back. I've already warmed the seat for you. I'm not an enemy agent. Honest, I'm not. Why don't you believe me?
I'll try. I'll try.
Try harder. What's the matter? Why are you looking at me like that? Well, I'm sorry, Matt. I guess there's no point in driving through town again. Well, maybe Wigwam isn't a name after all. Maybe we gotta find a place that looks like a wigwam.
And how do we do that?
Well, I don't know. Well, what do we do now?
We go back and I turn you in.
You're joking!
You knew there was nothing here. You lied to me.
That's not true.
Oh, you sent me on a wild goose chase knowing your friends would be waiting on the road.
I went with you.
You had to or go to prison. You never really believed they'd send you over too.
You never did change your mind about me, did you?
Oh, come on now. You didn't think you bought me off last night, did you? Where are you going?
Back to the motel. I need another bath.
Over, stupid.
License number to the San Juan police, but I don't think they'll be able to find him. Besides, he doesn't know the whole picture anyway, Matt.
No, they won't trust him with it. I've got to locate Cowboy.
Matt, we have to assume that everything is condition go as far as Operation Fallout's concerned, whatever it may be. That means you got 5 hours, Matt. You hear me? You got 5 hours to stop them.
Well, I guess I'll have to wait until she makes a move. And if she does, she's one of them. Oh, how's Tina? Mac? How's Tina?
Big old scatter, Matt. I'm sorry. I took her right out of the room, killed the guard. But there was no sign of a struggle in the room, so we have reason to believe she's still alive.
We're sure playing a cold deck.
Wigman to Big O.
We're surrounded. Oh, I think this is it, kid. At least we'll go out together.
Oh, Matt.
Mm-hmm. I'm sorry about what happened. I was only testing you.
I have been honest with you. And last night, most of all.
I know.
Do you? Oh, I just wish I could believe you.
Oh, I wouldn't lie to you at a time like this, just as I know you wouldn't lie to me.
No.
Oh, getting closer. Is there anything you want to tell me?
I've told you everything. I've been as honest with you as you have been with me.
Stop that.
I can't.
Try harder.
Well, I don't care what happens now. Just as long as I'm with you.
All right. Get up.
Oh, no.
Hello, Mr. Helm. Name is Wigman. Joe Wigman.
Wigman. Wigwam. My name is Chump. Matt Chump.
No! But wait, listen. I've got a message from Sarita.
Well, save it for later, huh, baby?
Well, kind of matches the outfit, doesn't it?
I've been waiting to meet you, cowboy.
To make a touch, huh?
That's right.
Well, I think Ice better check its intelligence. I'm not cowboy.
Oh. Well, who is? Or haven't they told you?
No, it's safer that way. Besides, it wouldn't make any difference to you right now anyway.
And I don't get to meet cowboy. Yeah. It's very disappointing. But all evens out because Big O is going to be disappointed, too.
Really? Why's that?
No computer tape and no fallout operation.
Well, everything's going right ahead on schedule anyway. The bomb and the missile.
Missile?
I am surprised at Ice. The missile is what makes it work.
Shut up.
There's no reason to give them a briefing session.
They're going to be dead pretty soon. It doesn't matter anyway.
Rather gaudy, shooting a man with his own gun.
Yeah, it kind of appeals to me. You like it, huh?
I've been thinking about you, Gunther. You're not executive material. I'm surprised that Big O is recruiting from the bottom of the barrel.
You're really asking for it, aren't you, Helm?
Low boiling point, too. That follows the pattern. Typical lightweight.
Oh, wait, Sam. Sam, I really do have a message from Sarita.
Will you please shut up?
Hold it.
Wigman to Big O. Wigman to Big O. Come in.
Big O to Wigman. We have been picking up your signal. Do you have Helm and the girl?
Yes.
This is Dunce. Bring them to command headquarters.
I understand.
Cowboy is here and is asking that they be kept alive. Temporarily.
We'll bring them in.
The countdown has started on Operation Fallout. You must be inside headquarters and at your post within the hour.
Will do.
Attention personnel, all level. Attention personnel, all level. The bomb phase of Operation Fallout is now go. Start decontaminators on all air vents. Repeat. Start decontaminators on all air vents. Attention. Attention Wigman. Attention Wigman. Report to Missile Control Center. The prisoners will wait for Cowboy outside the command room window. Countdown starting on underground test at Alamogordo continues.
Contact observation crew.
Six.
Tunse to observation crew.
Four.
Are you ready?
Three.
Mobile fallout shelter ready and standing by.
One.
Mr. Helm. I agreed to have you brought here because Cowboy wants the pleasure of eliminating you personally.
You must be a very nice man to work for. What's on the Late Late Show?
Operation Fallout. Cowboy and I are very anxious for you to see it. White Sands, Mr. Helm. That missile is about to take off for a target in the Pacific. From this point, we have cut into the coaxial cables of your missile network. Our computer is capable of taking over any missile fired within a radius of 500 miles.
Target control.
Since you stopped us from getting the computer tape, we had to bring Dr. Naldi here himself. It meant the end of our most important outside contact. But there was no other way. Having taken control, the computer will redirect the missile from its target in the Pacific to Alamogordo, where the underground bomb was just set off. The explosion will raise a cloud of radioactive dust that will settle over vast areas of the Southwest. Beautiful. Of course, Russia will be blamed. There will be accusations and counter-accusations. The two great powers will once again be on a collision course. For them, it will be the end. For us, the beginning. Well, Mr. Helm, if we don't see each other again, goodbye.
Ciao.
15 and a half minutes to blast off, and everything is a...
Now you know, Matt, which is the winning side.
Hello, Cowboy.
Oh, you know.
I recognize the whim. Want to eliminate us personally. Say hello to your teammate. You're Cowboy, well, in person. And you owe her an apology for roughing her up at the Slay Girl Club.
Well, I didn't realize I...
You weren't supposed to. Take her to the blue room, corridor D. Matt.
Wait.
Nothing will happen to her. Not until I give the signal. It's quite pleasant, really, if you don't mind blue. You can't change it. The question is, are you going to live through it?
I thought you've already decided that.
You didn't get the whim after all.
14 and a half minutes to blast off, and everything is A-OK.
Very chic.
Oh, I'm glad you like it.
What about your whim?
You don't understand. That's the only way I could get you over here alive. And that's the way I want you, Matt.
Is it?
I could have killed you a dozen times. I even saved your life, remember?
I bet that got a rise out of Tung Si. You had to shoot one of your own people.
It was worth it.
I doubt if he even complained about it. You know, you were valuable as a double agent. How long have you been with him?
13 and a half minutes.
One year.
That's a nice setup. Everything. You stay with ICE and you pass information to Big O. What could be better?
You can do the same.
I could do the same? What would my fringe benefits be? All this? You?
That's right. Come over to our side, Matt.
No, thank you. I'd rather fight than switch.
Is killing for us any different than killing for McDonald?
Yes.
You're making a big mistake. It's gonna be a long, cold night.
Maybe not as long and as cold as you think.
13 minutes to blast off.
You can't get to the computer. You'll be shot the minute you step out.
Oh, but they'll let you pass. Now, come on with me.
Why should I?
Well, it takes more guts than staying behind. Now, come on, Tina.
I don't like the odds. You'll just die.
Well, not in your bed.
What better place is there?
12 and a half minutes to blast off. And everything is A-OK.
Sorry, sweetheart. Orders. Goodbye, baby.
Mr. Helm, this is Dunce. You have caused us a great many problems, Mr. Helm. In spite of this, I am willing to make you an offer. Join us as double agent. Work with us against ICE. You're beaten, Helm. Come out now and you can have your life. On our terms, of course. Even the life of Miss Hendricks. You have 1 minute, Mr. Helm. Just 1 minute in which to think it over. Mr. Helm, it appears we shall have to do without you.
Well, they finally figured out how to get blood out of a stone.
Do that.
I must.
Don't say to Wigman.
The men tongue say?
Helm has broken into the tunnel.
We'll be ready and standing by. Men, plan number 3.
Don't say to observation crew. Proceed to control tower. Stop Helm.
Mobile.
Come in, observation crew. Come. Why don't they answer?
We've lost our picture. Please stand by.
You stupid man!
Thank you.
12 seconds.
Man, plan four.
3 minutes to blast off, and everything is A-okay.
The wind. If you see anybody, just point and shoot it.
If you were an Indian, Custer would still be alive.
On your feet, Helm.
1 minute to blast it off, and everything is A-OK.
Oh. Reset the controls. The coat, Helm. Take it off. It has caused us quite enough trouble. The coat, Mr. Helm. Or shall I put a bullet in this young woman's brain? And drop it in front of you.
Donald, I told you I'm not here. Don't bother calling back. I'm not expected. Would you hang this up for me?
Of course, Donald.
Forget it. I'm sorry, but you just reached a disconnected number. Hey, was that really you last night?
What do you mean, was that really me?
Well, you didn't do one single wrong thing.
You got to give a little. Get a little. Just make sure to get her wet a little. Now that's the story of, that's the glory of love.
Oh my God.